Hey friends, welcome back to my channel. And if you're new here, thank you so much for joining me for today's Christmas shop with me. I am so excited to take you guys to Hobby Lobby and Target, show you all of the super cute home decor I found for Christmas. And then at the very end of this video is gonna be a haul, so be sure to stick around. Like this video if you enjoy it. And if you're not subscribed to my channel, please make sure you do so. I'm gonna be pumping out so much Christmas content all season long. And let's go ahead and get started shopping. Climbs down the chimney at the speed of light while we're... So we're starting at Hobby Lobby, and the second I walked in, I noticed how incredibly organized my store was. They had a section for every color palette. This one was full of buffalo plaid. They also had one with golds, one with silvers, ones with multicolors. You name it, they have something there for you. And they had so many Christmas ornaments. I know I don't need any more Christmas ornaments, but I had to go browse because sometimes you can find Christmas ornaments that you can use in your house's other decor pieces. But you're gonna see so many different styles in this video. And if you haven't checked out Hobby Lobby yet, make sure you do so, because when I went, it was 50% off. I'm not sure if they're still running that deal, but that is definitely the time to go. Down and follow a route of all across the town. Lay it with me under the mistletoe. While Santa's busy saying ho, ho, ho. We're feeling jolly eating Christmas cake. And then we go skating on the frozen lake. Saying hi to every friendly face, and later we warm up by the fireplace. Carolers are singing outside our door, lovely songs we all heard before, as they walk from house to house to wish us all a Merry Christmas Day.
I'm sure that most of you guys know that Hobby Lobby has some of the best signage I have ever seen, and Christmas does not disappoint either. They had so many different color palettes in these signs as well. This whole section here was just traditional red and white. They had red, white, and green, and then they had a bunch of neutral colored items, signs, and little plush animals and different things like that. So I really do believe they have something for everybody here, and a lot of their stuff was super, super affordable, even some of the bigger items. I didn't get any big items just because I do have a smaller home, so I don't have anywhere to put giant things, but if you're looking for some big statement pieces, then the 50% off at Hobby Lobby would be a great time to buy them. As we walk from house to house to wish us all a Merry Christmas Day. Yeah. A Merry Christmas Day.
So the next place I went was Target, and my first stop in Target was the Hearth and Hand collection, and I really do believe that Joanna Gaines just nails it every single year with the decor for each season. They had so many amazing pieces. This wreath was so gorgeous. They had lots of serving pieces like platters and plates and cups and you name it, they had it, pillows. And just so many great soft neutral colors. And then I checked out the Opal House collection and some of the other spots in Target. My Target was a little bit sparse. I don't feel like they had put everything out yet, but I took a look at some of the like softer textures, blankets and pillows, and I did stop by the candle aisle, but I'm probably gonna wait and get some Bath and Body Works candles. So I took a look at the ornaments and stockings and other things, and I'm definitely gonna have to go back because I just feel like they hadn't put everything out at my Target yet. Okay, so I'm back home now, and as you guys can see behind me, I laid out all of my Christmas stuff from
years past, and I always like to do this before I go shopping just so I can see what I already have. Also, I really like to stick with the same kind of color palette, and that way I know when I go shopping and I see something that matches with that color palette and with that scheme that it will fit perfectly. And I just tend to have the same style from year to year, so there's not a whole lot here that I wouldn't put out. But I got quite a few things at Hobby Lobby, and as you saw, everything was 50% off, which is a great deal. And all of the Thanksgiving stuff was on sale too. So we are hosting a Friendsgiving toward like the end of November, beginning of December. So I did pick up a couple Thanksgiving-y things for that. And then I also got a few Christmas things. I got one item at Target and one at Sam's Club. And there wasn't a lot at Target, so I'm probably gonna go back after I decorate. And if there's any like missing little holes in my decor, then I'll probably go back to Target and fill in with some of those things. But I'm gonna stop rambling and let's go ahead and get started with what I got at Hobby Lobby. So I have a tiered tray that I'm gonna decorate this year for Christmas. So I got a couple of really small items that would look so cute on the tiered tray. And the first one is this little bistro cup, and it would be super cute for an espresso, but I'm just gonna use this as a decor piece. And this was $2.99, so it was $1.50. And things like this, if you have a tiered tray, are perfect because they're so inexpensive and they add just a really fun pop of color. And I may put some things in here too. I haven't decided yet. Maybe some like little Christmas picks or something would look super cute. But I got this, and then I also got this for the tiered tray. And it is an ornament, I guess, because it has a little like a twine attached to it. And this was $5. So this was $2.50 for this little guy. And I am just so obsessed with how this looks. I love the wreath and the little bow. And it looks just like a little lantern outside. But I'm probably going to cut the string off and then use this on the tiered tray as well, because I think the red and everything just kind of coordinates really well. But when you're shopping for a tiered tray, definitely look in the ornament section, because a lot of those ornaments can be used as just little decor pieces, not on a tree. So that's the idea I have for this guy, and I think it is so sweet. And that little lantern actually matches this one, which is funny because this was considered a Christmas piece, even though you could totally use this like all year, and I'm probably going to use it all year, but I got it for 50% off because it's considered Christmas. So this was $5, which means this lantern was $2.50. Yeah, $2.50, crazy. So this thing is super cute, and it's got a little spot in the bottom where you can put a tea light. So I may or may not put a light in here. Sometimes I like to use lanterns with Christmas ornaments, like put them inside the lantern, or little like floral pieces, like if I cut up little floral pieces and put them inside. So we'll see how I end up using this, but definitely when you're at a place like Hobby Lobby, look for things that you can use all year round, because they're usually part of the Christmas or the spring collection, but you can use it all the time and get that 50% off. I have an idea for a garland that I already have, but I kind of want to dress it up a little bit. It has lights. I may end up getting some flocking spray and actually flocking it too. I haven't fully decided yet, but regardless, I'm probably going to use these wooden red beads with that. And I love these because they look like cranberries, and they're just so, so pretty. And I have a lot of reds. I love traditional colors. If you can't tell, I love greens and reds and white too. But I'm not really much of like a shiny, glamorous kind of decor gal. But this is going to look really sweet, either woven in with some of my garland, or I may end up using it in the tree. I'm not sure it would be enough to do the whole tree. Maybe my small tree that I put upstairs would look really sweet. But this was, let's see. So this was a little more expensive. This is $8 because it's wooden, but I got it for 50% off, so it was $4. But I guess just because of the texture, the fact that it's made out of wood is probably why it's a little bit more. And it also is 9 feet, so that's pretty long. So definitely good for like a piece of garland or something like that, but I love the color. So if you guys saw my fall Hobby Lobby video and you saw my fall decorate with me, then you probably saw that I got two of these types of little stands in like fall colors. And so I decided to only get one for the Christmas colors. I may end up going back and getting another one, but I love to put my hand soap or my dish soap on this, either in the bathroom or by the kitchen sink. I may end up using this in the bathroom and just putting the hand soap in the bathroom on this. I haven't really decided, but these are so inexpensive. So this was $2, and it's just a really cute way to like elevate your hand soap people put hand soaps and dish soaps in their bathrooms and their kitchens anyway. So if you can turn that into a decor piece for a couple of bucks, then that's a great way to add a little pop of color. But I think they had these, I didn't see any other colors. So if I went back, I would want to get a different color because I think it looks cute when there's like a red and a green. I think the ones that I got for fall were orange and green. So anyway, super sweet little way to decorate. Okay, so the next two things I kind of bought to go together, and I have an idea because I already have, I think, at least one of this type of tree, and then I may have a couple others that are even smaller than these guys, but I love these bottle brush trees. I think that they are so sweet, and I love the way that they look when they're flocked. They have a ton of different ones, as you saw in the video, the clips that I showed you from Hobby Lobby. So if you like more of a glamorous style, they have shiny ones. They have ones in really fun, bold colors if you don't love traditional Christmas colors, but I went with the traditional Christmas colors. So this guy is so cute, and you can see it has like the little plaid bow and then the little star at the top, and I just love this little tree. I think it is so cute. It kind of reminds me of the Charlie Brown tree. I don't know why, but it does. So this is probably going to go either by itself or with some of the other smaller ones that I have from last year. And then along with that, I got this set, and the set is the way to go because, so this guy was $2.50 just for this one, and then this was $2.50 for three. So $2.50 for three little trees, and these are cute. You can put them all together to make it look like a forest of trees, or you can put them like individually, mix and match. They have different sizes, so you could do like one big one and a bunch of small ones and create like a little village. These are really inexpensive, but they are so, so sweet. And like I said, they had so many different colors. So they had other ones if you don't love the red and green. Our plan was to do Christmas cards this year just because I think that it's really sweet. And 2020 has been such a tough year that I think family would really love to get a Christmas card from people saying, this is what I've been up to this year and things like that. So Jack and I really wanted to write Christmas cards and send them to our families. And so they have giant packs of these at Hobby Lobby. This is 20 cards and 20 envelopes, and we're probably not going to find more than 20 people to send these to. But this is what the outside of it looks like. So it's just the buffalo plaid, and it says Merry Christmas in this like gold foil. Really pretty. And then on the inside, I love that you can see what the card looks like because they include one on the outside of the box. And so the inside little message here, which I love, so it says, may your blessings be many, may your joy be great. And then what we were thinking is we would just print off a letter and then just like put it on the inside and then send it like that. So we've never done Christmas cards before, but I just thought this is the year that people would probably really appreciate getting a letter in the mail. So we're gonna probably do that. All right, so only a couple more things from Hobby Lobby, and this guy right here, I love. And this is another one of those things that you would think this is super expensive. This was $5. So I just love it. I love the little red truck with the Christmas trees on it. Super cute. And again, sticking with the theme, like these little green trees, if you put this near some of these other green trees, I just think it goes so well together. But this was really cute. And a lot of their wooden things are so inexpensive. And it has little hooks on the back so you can do, like you can hang it on the wall. I'll probably just set it like on top of a table or something like that. But love this. And they had so many different kinds. I had a really hard time choosing. So the last Christmas thing from Hobby Lobby is a tree topper because I did not have one last year. In fact, I don't think I've ever had a tree topper. So Hobby Lobby is the place to get one because this was, I guess, $7. I guess it'd be $7. And it's pretty big. Like it's like the size of my head. But I love the flocking and I love the colors on it and everything. It has the little pine cone. And I think that the tree topper will work really well with all of the colors that are in my like decor, but also the way I decorate the tree. I'm probably gonna decorate the same way that I did last year. Last year, I got these really awesome pics from, I think, Michaels. And last year, I didn't have a YouTube channel, so I did not film anything. So if there is stuff that I have that I bought last year, when I do my Christmas decorate with me, I will link everything that I possibly can for you guys. But I did little picks that had these little cranberries and I just stuck them into the tree all around the tree. And then I did ribbon throughout the tree. So I just think that all these colors will look so good together. I'm really, really excited. So like I said, I got some Thanksgiving stuff because it was on sale too, and we're doing a Friendsgiving. So I just got some little plates. And I think these are actually going to end up being dessert plates because we got some bigger ones from some family that will probably work better for a dinner plate. So this one says thankful, and then I just got the matching napkins that go with it. And I just love those colors. And then we just picked up a little pack of these place cards. So there's 20 of them. And then we can write everybody's name on them. You could probably make these yourself too, but I don't have time for that, so I went ahead and bought them. But I wanted to show you the two items. I got one at Sam's Club and one at Target. And like I said, I'll probably go back to Target. But I got this pack from the Dollar Spot of these little galvanized houses because I could not get these. And I have from last year, it's over there, but you'll see it in my Decorate With Me video. I have a red house that matches these little galvanized ones perfectly. And I'm now kind of in love with the idea of doing like some kind of village with the little trees and the little houses. I just think that would look so stinking cute. So we'll see how I end up decorating. I'm just going to let myself be inspired. But this was a really good deal for these three. And then the last thing is a giant pillow I found at Sam's Club. And I have a feeling that our cat is going to probably go bananas with this pillow. But it's a giant pillow that says Merry Christmas. And it has the little green bells on the ends. So Josie will probably go crazy with this pillow, but I thought it was too sweet not to pick up. And it would look really nice either on my bed because it's really big. And I love these rectangular pillows for my bed or the guest bed. It would look really sweet. I have one that's really good for the living room and all that. But that is everything that I got from Hobby Lobby and a little Target and a little Sam's Club. But I will definitely be doing a Bath & Body Works haul and a Grove Collaborative haul. So there's going to be several more hauls this Christmas season. So definitely be sure to subscribe to my channel if you're not, so that way you don't miss any of my Christmas content. This is my first Christmas doing YouTube stuff because last year I did not have my channel. And I am beyond excited to share all of these things with you. So definitely be sure to hit the like button if you enjoyed this video. And if you're not subscribed, please, please subscribe before you go. I would love to have you. And I will see you guys again next week with a brand new video. Bye, guys. We'll put our